don't suppose. No. Oh wait, I can get over there. Oh.
Shh, easy now.
Well, we got ladders. Oh. Oh my God. Don't ever do that again. I climbed through her.
Byzantium estates. Terror built on the backs of the working class.
Oh, cool.
Hey, that was good. Gotta write that down.
Move along.
So what if all those MSIs continued on one time? I could do it. Easy.
Sweet. I'm not going char trans yet. Is that on a... Estates. Well, we'll see it if we... Yeah. I'll come back here.
There's my parents' place. Smell that? Industrial grade cleaning solvent and desperation.
Ah, so it's not me this time. Whew.
A UDL security attendant is always prepared.
A UDL security attendant is always prepared.
So this is your parents' place. Yeah, let's go visit them. Why not? Wow. From this to being a pirate?
Marilyn, is that you?
Lars, we certainly didn't expect to see you like this.
I can see the resemblance.
And I didn't expect you to renew your marriage contract.
Huh.
But we're all full of surprises today, aren't we?
Oh my.
Speaking of surprises, you should meet my new friend. We've been running around the system for a while now, stirring up all sorts of trouble.
Yeah, definitely not gonna choose number three. It's a pleasure to meet you. Thank you for welcoming us into your home. Not that you've actually had a even chance to do that.
I don't know what to say. She's usually not like this. Come on, you're supposed to help me make an impression.
What kind of impression?
Anyway, you're probably wondering where I've been all this time.
Not exactly.
Ladle with a spoon.
The last few years have been a bloody haze. You wouldn't believe the messes we've gotten ourselves into.
Years?
Right?
I guess this is what she wants. Theft, vandalism, profanity, you named it. You name it, we've done it at least twice.
Yep, we're a pair of disgraceful lowlives.
So I was supposed to spit on the floor and do that.
Marilyn, this really isn't the best time. Perhaps you should go.
We'll leave when we're good and ready.
You tell him. We'll stay as long as we like. And while we're at it, we'll drink your expensive hooch, wear our outside shoes all over your nice floors.
You guys have hooch? Hold up. These floors aren't just nice, they're top quality marble.
She's right. Since when can you afford authentic Terran marble?
That's what we've been trying to tell you, dear, but you must understand, we hadn't heard from you in ages.
We thought you were dead.
Don't sound so disappointed about it.
I'm not dead. I just never wanted to talk to you again.
I'm afraid the distinction was lost on us, darling.
Why do I get the feeling that you people are about to apologize for something?
We only did what any grieving parents in our position would do. We collected on your life insurance policy.
What?
And the payouts have been rather substantial.
Well,
you what?
She's not dead, so you're probably gonna owe that money. I'm sure you're much happier now knowing Ellie's alive and well, right?
Of course. And we shall always harbor that joyful secret deep within our hearts.
Right.
And you'll report it to the insurance company, right?
That's the secret part.
It's not that simple. For one thing, we'd have to cut back on so many necessities. The neighbors would be sure to notice.
So tell them Ellie's back. You'll be the talk of the town.
That's the other problem.
We had to explain your disappearance somehow.
We couldn't very well tell people you'd run off to become a miscreant, could we?
Now, I'll have you know that Ellie's a professional miscreant.
Shh. Someone could hear you.
You better hear me.
We concocted a story about Celeste Jolly Girl designing a pair of 12-inch heels for you.
One of a kind, naturally.
She'd really wear that.
That led to your tragic death when you tripped and broke your neck.
It was quite the story. People were talking about it for weeks.
Of all the ways to go. I'm just gonna listen at this point.
Couldn't you have at least made up a better story? Something with pirates or raptodons?
Yeah, really.
And what are you gonna do now that we're here?
Yes, about that. We were just about to ask you to, leave.
Quietly, if you don't mind.
If you really knew your daughter, you'd know that quiet is not in her vocabulary.
She hasn't changed a bit, I see.
So you do know her.
That's it? You just want us to disappear now?
Marilyn, please.
Don't cause a scene.
I don't know about you, Ellie, but I'm ready to cause a scene.
Let's just get out of here, Captain. Fine. I'm gone. Forever this time.
Really? It's just gonna end like this? Follow up with Ellie.
Let's just put this unpleasantness behind us.
Ugh. Stupid. Sofa.
Could you please leave quietly now?
We don't do quietly, you know that. High society cigarettes. Got your cigarettes. Wait, it's gonna be under. Yeah. The finest cigarettes for the most discerning smoker. Ellie was understandably dismayed to find that her parents had declared her dead and were living off her life insurance money. She probably needs to talk somewhere away from her folks. Yeah. Well, I want to look around the rest of this place. If there's anything here. Kind of works so we can just take this stuff, because I was going to take it anyway. Anything else? Oh, it's moving. It's her moving. Let's talk outside.
Can we talk?
Yeah, absolutely.
Can you believe those two?
Not really.
We'd hardly been there a minute and they turned us out like yesterday's garbage.
They shouldn't have gotten so upset.
I wanted them to get upset. I just thought it would play out differently. They'd both be sitting there watching one of their vapid aetherwave dramas, and then we'd walk in. Mother would drop her mock apple cider, and the glass would shatter all over their overpriced marble. Father would tear off his glasses and blink open-mouthed.
This is a very specific fantasy.
I'm getting to the good part.
Okay.
I'd have a great one-liner in the tube. I was thinking either, the leather's fake, but the scars are real, or, oops, did I just track awesome onto your rug?
All right, so this is interesting. I'm using intimidate, but not on her necessarily. On the idea of this scene. How about, it's payback time, and I'm collecting with interest.
Yeah, I'm gonna use that one day. Now, getting back to my story.
Okay.
Father would throw his hands up because this would be just like me to come back and make a big scene. Then Mother would do the old, you had us worried sick. Her eyes would be red and she'd have her fist in front of her mouth to stifle a sob.
You're really hurt, aren't you?
I'm not hurt. I'm outraged. Affronted, even. I just didn't want to get booted out of the house I grew up in like that. It's embarrassing, you know. And I've got a reputation to maintain.
I'm sorry. It's a rough situation.
I'm used to rough situations. Like when someone loads your pistol with blanks and strands you in a Marauder moon base, or traps you in an airlock with an angry mantis worm.
This episode reflects on them, not you.
But I want to talk about me now.
You've got to surround yourself with people who will really look out for you.
Unless you mean the kind who'll look out for you to blink so they could swipe your bits. The galaxy's not exactly crawling with those. Anyway, I don't want to sift through this lousy experience for meaningful life lessons. I'm mad, and I want to do something about it. Something like... Wait a second. What if I could get that money?
Keep talking.
I could open a new account, designate that account holder as a sole beneficiary. All the payouts would go to me.
How would that work?
I'll make money without doing a thing. And I'll get to cut them off.
Okay. The only problem is, how can you change the beneficiary of an insurance plan when the insured person has been declared dead? And then you're gonna declare yourself the beneficiary of yourself. How do we do that?
My policy is with the Greater Halcyon Insurance Group. They have an office in Byzantium.
Right.
Maybe you could use some of your people skills to help me set up a dummy beneficiary account. If that doesn't work, I'm sure we can find one of their terminals and do it ourselves.
Okay. Can I ask you something else?
Something on your mind?
No, actually. Insurance office, okay. If anyone's going to make money off of Ellie's arranged death, Ellie figures it should be her. Find the Greater Halcyon Insurance Group in Byzantium and set things straight. That's the Acropolis District. How big is this place?
Move along.
Did you hear? Marjorie Dalton and Archibald Harris are redecorating with real crystal faux windows.
Real faux.
Don't they know those went out of style 3 weeks ago?
So did their marriage, apparently. I'd wager my inverted bathtub she backs out of the contract first.
I thought those were mines under the benches.
You must be joking. Our fair city is being overrun by a pox of... Oh, there! That's one right there. Can't you just see the stench of impropriety radiating off of her?
I beg your pardon.
For the last time. Access to Byzantium is impossible without a proper nav key. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to be somewhere else.
He left quickly, and now you're just sitting.
How splendid. Another rung leech wandering through the streets of Byzantium. Why, just this morning, I thought to myself, as lovely as the gardens are, what they really need is more greasy vagrants frolicking through them.
Charmed.
And here you are, frolicking.
Frolicking. Guys, do I frolic?
Hey, it's nothing to be ashamed of. Own it.
Hey.
Well, whatever you call it, do it elsewhere, and take your merry band with you. Honestly, what is the board thinking, letting so many of your ilk into the city proper? It's madness.
If the board isn't supposed to let people into the city, then how did you get here?
I earned my place here, just like everyone else. My grandfather was the CIO at Tile, you see.
What's a CIO?
Chief Idea Officer.
Idea.
He came up with all the best ideas for their products. You know the font they use for Stogie Slims? That was him. Well, he described the idea of it to their font development team, then picked it from a list of choices, but that's basically the same thing.
No.
It was a very long list.
No, it's not. Wait, but what did you do to earn your place here?
I just told you. My grandfather made millions of bits as CIO, and I earned them from him.
Inheriting bits isn't the same as earning them.
Of course it is. Wealth is the most visible, objective measure of success. And success isn't given to you, it's earned. My grandfather taught me that.
You did not
earn. If you have wealth, you're successful. And if you're successful, you must have earned it. Honestly, it's a simple concept.
The only one simple around here is you.
You're welcome. Now, do we have any further business, or are you just here for the repartee?
I'm here for the repartee. What's wrong with more people coming to Byzantium?
What's wrong? It erodes the very pillars of our society. Merit, decorum, personal hygiene.
Oh, the humanity.
This city is meant for us, the system's finest. We earned its luxuries. But now we are overrun with the unworthy and the ungrateful, and this early retirement nonsense is making it even worse.
What's early retirement?
The worst thing to happen to Halcyon. A contest that gives even the lowliest, most inefficient workers a chance to live in Byzantium. By simply winning a lottery, those early retirees get an exclusive district of Byzantium to themselves. No one else is even allowed to go there. Tell me, how is that fair?
You know what, lady? Life's not fair.
Well, it should be if you pay enough. It's not right. I deserve to see any district I please. Why, if it weren't guarded, I'd... You know, you look like you've been shot at before.
Who, me?
What say I hire you to investigate this travesty, and you get paid to do so?
She ain't wrong, boss. We do got a knack for getting shot at.
Well, she's insulting to us.
Listen to your...
friend.
What is that person's job exactly? Are they your secretary? Personal masseuse? Or do you just keep them around as a mobile armrest? Well, it doesn't matter. What's important is that you think this is a fabulous arrangement, and you'd be thrilled to lend me your services. Aren't you?
Why would I ever help you with something so selfish?
Did you miss the part where I said I'd pay you? That's all the reason someone like you should require.
I do like money.
Fantastic. Consider yourself employed, Vagrant.
I hear the chosen
retirees all enter the retirement district via the port landing pad, but it's completely locked down. You'd never get in that way. Unless, of course, you had a wealthy, beautiful benefactor of impeccable social pedigree, which you do. How fortunate for you. These codes will get you past the lockdown. Oh, and don't worry about subtlety. I don't care how you deal with security, just correct this injustice at all costs.
You're not as beautiful as you think you are, but how'd you get those access codes?
The same way anyone gets anything here, of course. I made friends with the right people. Bits might earn you a place in Byzantium, but that means everyone here has little need for more of them. For favors like this, you need to spend... let's call it social capital.
Alright, fine. We're gonna... she insults us and we're gonna help her. A resident of Byzantium, Hortense Ingalsbee, has asked you to investigate the board's early retirement program. Use the password Hortense gave you to access it via terminal. Quests! We can't go in there.
The Emerald Veil plant is
out to brunch. Whatever that place is. Sisty chops. Oh, look at that. We got a security thingy. What's this place?
This property is off limits. Solicitors, loiterers, and uninvited visitors will be fined to the fullest extent of company policy. This ultimatum brought to you by Universal Defense Logistics.
Oh, yeah, not gonna mess with Mr. Clark just yet. So that's Clark's residence. There's Billings leaves. Let me just take a peek over there, cause.
Hey, Ellie. When was it that you realized the board was crushing the life out of this colony?
What are you talking about?
Oh, I know where we
talking
are.
Talking about the board? The machine of oppression? Ain't that why you became a pirate? Because you wanted to be free and all?
I'm just after a paycheck, kid.
Huh. Oh wait, we got a bigger one over here.
You gotta teach me that.
Pay attention, kid. You might learn something. Ooh. Alright, so... what is up here? The arrow... the Acropolis District. So inviting with these people standing here with us, Reaper scythes and stuff.
Hey, you!
Don't kill me.
What do you think you're doing?
I was just leaving.
Just don't make more paperwork for me, alright?
Nah. Paranoid. No. I don't want to take that. I decreased my board reputation.
The Acropolis District is off limits. Move along.
Mind if I take a breather? I'm pretty tired after hauling around all these bits.
You could have asked me, you know.
Yes, you are.
What in the law's name are you on about?
That's probably all my money. This is embarrassing. I was going to bribe you, but I realize I don't have enough on me.
Honest mistake. Why don't you come back another time and we can take this from the top?
Alright, I'm not looking for trouble. I just went in there.
Yeah, and I'd really like a new Hammersmith grenade launcher. Hammersmith, the most trusted brand in brutality. But we can't all have what we want. And seeing as you don't seem the executive sort, you obviously don't belong in the Acropolis district.
You don't know that.
Hey, were you awarded most persons profiled 6 non-consecutive months in a row? I didn't think so.
You get paid by the word, Officer Windbag?
As a matter of fact, I get paid per profile, you marginally employed 20-something male with more guts than sense.
Oh.
Anyway, I've worked here long enough to know every clerk by name and face. And since I don't know yours, you ain't getting through.
You don't know me because I'm new to the job. I'm starting at the ministry tomorrow.
You're new to the ministry? You one of those lab coats they promoted from a company town?
You ever heard of Stimulotion? I developed the active compound.
That was yours? Wow. You earned that promotion, all right.
Thank
you. So you start tomorrow, huh? You know, they should have set you up with an ID 6 to 8 weeks ago.
Yeah, I know, but it never arrived. I tried to file a complaint.
But then you had to wait 6 to 8 weeks for the complaint forms to arrive, right?
Mm-hmm.
I've been there.
Don't you know
yeah,
it.
All right. You're good to go.
Awesome. And we got to keep all our money. Hi.
Move along.
I developed the active component for Stimulotion.
Nothing exciting ever happens around here.
You need some Stimulotion, that's why.
So what if those MSI suits made it on Marnark this whole time? I could do it.
Move along.
Bort's just showing off.
Acropolis District.
Our UDL security attendant is always prepared.
So where does this go? Does it say? Maintenance tunnels. I don't want to do that just yet. HHC building.
Sorry, I shouldn't talk. Not without signing a waiver.
Hi.
Sorry, I shouldn't talk. Not without signing a waiver.
Ministry of Accuracy and Morale key.
Sorry, I shouldn't talk.
Sorry, I shouldn't talk.
I got you guys trained well. I hope I've seen everything. HHC building. Oh, Halcyon Holdings Corp. So we have anything going on here? Clark's that way. Oh, we skipped the Odeon Pictures building. I haven't seen the Greater Halcyon Insurance Group. Yeah, I guess next episode, Halcyon Holdings Corp, and then look for the Insurance Group, and whatever else might be nearby, and then Odeon Pictures, and whatever else might be nearby. Well, the last two, not necessarily in that order. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.